Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, My Mind is Art. So how are you guys doing? So this is another video from my Canada series. I'm pre-filming this video basically because I want you guys to see some content on my channel while I'm busy settling in Canada. So if you're new here, then please don't forget to hit like, share and please subscribe to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about all the expenses which you are going to meet in India. Basically, how much money is it going to cost for you to go and live your dream of studying in Canada. So in this video, basically, I'm going to talk about your pre-arrival expenses and like including your tuition fees and everything. So if you're interested in knowing, then please continue watching. Also, if you're new here, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, so if you're watching this video, then obviously it means ki haan, aapka bhi sapna hai to go to Canada. And mera bhi sapna tha, and yeah, I am living that dream now. So let's start. Sabse pehla expense jo hota hai, pre-arrival. Pre-arrival means when you haven't arrived and you are just planning, the first thing you need to do is give your IELTS exam. If you want to know more about what is IELTS, then you can check out the video I have listed here. Okay, so jo IELTS ka exam hota hai, uska price bahut uniform hai. When I gave my IELTS, it costed me ₹12,650. And if you convert it into CAD, Canadian dollars, then it comes around $234. So, okay, so now let's talk about the second expense. The second expense which you will need to meet is your application fees. So, ab aapne apna IELTS exam de diya. Now you need to apply to colleges. And while you're applying to colleges, you have a huge pool of colleges to choose from. And mostly her college ki apni application fees hoti hai, which ranges from $90 to $150 in, like, obviously Canadian dollars we are talking about here. And if we convert that into INR, then it ranges from around 5,000 to 8,000 rupees. So ye aapka alag next expense hota hai. There are colleges which have zero application fees, but most of the colleges now have their application fees. Okay, so one more thing I would like to clear is that the application fees ka amount hai, $90 to $150, this is for each college. Har ek college mein aapko aisa apply karna padega. So in this total, like if we are talking here, then we're calculating on the assumption that we applied kiya at least 3 colleges mein. And ek college ki approximately 100 Canadian dollar fees hai, so 3 colleges ki ho gai, 300 Canadian dollars, which ranges to approximately 15 to 17,000 rupees. Now after you have applied for various colleges and courses, then is the time for you to wait for your offer letter. So after receiving your offer letter, aapko pay karni hogi apne course ki tuition fees. Ab tuition fees generally, if we talk about 1 year, then different courses and different colleges pe depend karti hai ye fees, and mostly it ranges in between the bracket of 15,000 to 20,000 Canadian dollars. So that means in INR it lies between around 10 lakhs to 15 lakhs rupees for a year. So this is the next third expense which you will be meeting. Now next expense if we talk about is your medical test. After you have accepted your offer letter, the next thing which you need to do is go and get your medical test done, because medical test aapko zarurat hogi while filing for your visa. So if you talk about the medical test har state ka apna alag alag institutes bane hue hain wahan par hota hai. I am from Delhi. So maine Delhi mein jab apna test karaya tha, to it costed me ₹5700 plus 3100 because I have tattoos. So total amounts to 8800, and in Canadian dollars it means $150 to $200 approximately. So if you have a tattoo, then you will have to pay 3100 rupees extra, and if you don't have a tattoo, then of course 5700. But it ranges between, like, it differs from state to state, and you may be charged around 4500 to 7000 rupees again. As I said, it depends on which state you are from. After getting your medical test done, you need to pay your GIC. GIC, again, I have made another video, you can check it out. So GIC is Guaranteed Investment. Okay, so GIC is Guaranteed Investment Certificate. This is basically aapka ek saal jo aap rehne wale ho, uska pura expense jo aap Canadian government ko ek security de rahe ho ki haan aapko aap apne aap ko wahan par survive kar loge. So GIC is that, and the minimum amount which is issued by the CIC is 10,200 Canadian dollars, which amounts to approximately 5.5 lakhs in INR. So the next expense is your GIC amount. GIC amount, again, if necessity hai for filing your visa, so you cannot eliminate that expense as well. After filing your GIC, you need to apply for your student visa. Jo maine bhi expenses upar mention kare, after meeting these expenses only, you can apply for student visa. So next comes the student visa. Student visa ke charges hai $235, which amounts to approximately 13 to 14,000 rupees. So this is your next expense. And after filing for your student visa, you need to wait for your visa, of course. And once you have received your visa, congratulations if you have already. So after receiving your visa, the next step is to book your flight. Now, flight in India ranges from 60,000 rupees to 1 lakh rupees. It again depends on your personal choice. Which flight do you want? How many stops do you want in your flight? What do you want the duration of your flight to be? It depends. And if you talk about it in Canadian dollars, then it ranges from around 1000 Canadian dollars to 1500 Canadian dollars. Now, the second last expense which you are going to meet is your accommodation for the initial days. We are just talking about the initial days because that you have to book from, pre-book from India itself. And that may be your, maybe a hotel or a Airbnb. The booking amount ranges from approximately 7,000 to 10,000 rupees. And if you talk about it in Canadian dollars, then it ranges from approximately 200 to 250 Canadian dollars. So, ये आपका second last खर्चा है. Obviously, आपको booking पहले से ही करानी पड़ेगी. मैं यहाँ पर post arrival, जो आपकी accommodation होगी, उसकी बात नहीं कर रही हूँ, because that will be accounted in post arrival expenses. But pre arrival, जो आपको यहीं से खर्चा करके जाना पड़ेगा, we are just talking about that in video, and hence hotel या Airbnb आपको पहले ही book करना पड़ेगा. इसलिए we are talking about that expense in this video. Now, last expense, which is completely subjective, which is your shopping. आप चाहे तो zero shopping करके जाओ या फिर आप 10 lakhs की shopping करके जाओ, it obviously, it's very subjective. So, in my case, I shopped around 1 lakh rupees aram se because I had to buy my luggage, I had to buy a lot of things. Like, 1 lakh is the upper limit. Shopping बहुत ही ज़्यादा subjective है. आप, as I said, हो सकता है आप सिर्फ 10,000 की करो, 5,000 की करो, 20,000 की करो, हो सकता है आप सिर्फ 1,000 की करो. It obviously depends कि आपकी क्या need या क्या wants है. So, upper limit, let's take around 1 lakh rupees because it may go up till there. Now, if we add all the expenses, it amounts to be approximately 18 lakh Indian rupees, which amounts to 33,000 Canadian dollars. So this is the amount which you need if you want to study in Canada, which is 18,000 Indian rupees, sorry, 18 lakh Indian rupees and 33,000 Canadian dollars. This to you guys that this expense or these expenses are for an year. ये नहीं है कि आपने एक बार 18 लाख जो आप दे रहे हो वो सिर्फ जाने जाने में नहीं खर्चा हो रहा है एक तरह से इसमें, क्योंकि आपका 5.5 लाख का एडवांस पेमेंट आप कर रहे हो फॉर योर एक्सपेंसिस विच यू विल बी नीडिंग टू मीट इन योर ड्यूरिंग योर कोर्स. एक साल का कोर्स की हम यहाँ पे बात कर रहे हैं, उसी की हम एक्सपेंसिस की बात कर रहे हैं. सिमिलरली आपकी जो ट्यूशन फीस है वो दो सेमेस्टर की है, तो आपने एक सेमेस्टर का यहाँ से दिया तो दूसरा सेमेस्टर का भी आपने एडवांस पे कर दिया है. सो दैट वे आपका एक जो ये पूरा है 18 लाख, ये आपका सारा स्टडी करने का भी खर्चा है एंड आपका वहाँ पे रहने सहने का भी खर्चा है, एवरीथिंग इंक्लूडेड. सो और वन मोर थिंग, 18 लाख में मैंने सब कुछ हायर अमाउंट लिया है, मैंने किसी का भी मिनिमम अमाउंट नहीं लिया. तो मैक्सिमम टू मैक्सिमम आपके 18 लाख रुपीज लगेंगे इफ यू आर गोइंग टू कैनेडा ऑन स्टूडेंट वीजा अंडर SDS स्कीम. सो इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर अ वन ईयर कोर्स. So that's it guys, if you have any other query related to Canada or about the study process, immigration process or any other thing, please don't forget to leave it in the comments section below. I would love to attend that query and I would love to answer it for you guys. I would love to make a video. So yeah, that's it. I will see you in my next one. I hope now you are cleared with how much money you need. Yeah, bye bye.